Let's get it.
Sheesh. Edwards 40 hands. We got fucking baby boy collars. The graveyard. A round of applause.
Let's get it.
Hope you guys are in for a fucking great one tonight. We're going to start off by cracking the fucking Millers. Right. You know what I'm saying? Get it by the microphone. Oh, nothing better than a man can fucking hear. A Miller Lite 40. The goal of this one is to make sure we finish this fucking 40 by the end of the podcast, which I think is easy. Yeah. You know, maybe next one will go two 40s in a hand, and I might be a little doozy, but this one will be fucking fine.
My hand's freezing already. It's cold. Hand's freezing. I'm trying to get this off.
You gotta chug this shit off.
I just hit it crazy.
Nah, it's fine. If you want to chug it, yeah, my hands are fucking freezing. If you do want to chug it, it's fine.
As long as you finish it before
the podcast. Yeah, as long as you finish, you know, otherwise you're getting loose. One that doesn't finish the last, got to take a tequila shot, something like that, whatever, you know, but that's maybe after the pod.
Tastes good, though. I'm not going to even lie. I'm kind of low-key on an empty stomach, too.
Oh, me as well, me as well.
Yeah, all right, let's... Miller's not that bad.
No, it's good, right? Well, yeah, have you ever had a Miller Lite?
Nope.
I've had a 40. Miller Life. Or this is High Life, right? Yeah, High
Life. I think I've only had one of these ever in
It's a Miller, though.
Miller High Life?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. I mean, I feel like it's pretty... like close to like a Mexican beer, almost there. Yeah, it's like a little light, but it's almost there. You know, it's like, it's not. It's like me. It's like, you know, Mexican, but like you know, doesn't know Spanish. That's like, what this beer is right here. It's in the same realm, but it's not totally fucking Hispanic.
Like you're close, but you're not there.
You're like fucking around.
All right, let's start off with the fucking misconnection. If these people don't know, wait, don't read it.
Okay, my bad.
If these people don't know, misconnection is a fucking Craigslist little subcategory. You click on it, people write to each other and everything. This comes out from LA. The title, it says Game of Catch, or actually this says Lancaster. I've heard some shit about Lancaster.
I've heard about it.
All right, let's start it. Ex-baseball player. In my 50s, looking for other like-minded athletes for a game of catch. I can pitch or catch. Want to get back into playing shape, so would love to find a regular workout partner. Pitcher needed. Short stick, okay. Yo! Okay, this guy wasn't fucking slick, dude. You know what he's talking about?
This was on some shit. Yeah.
This guy's a gremlin, dude, bro.
I was dead ass like, oh, maybe he just wants a baseball partner.
No. You got to read the fine print. He's like looking for...
But look at the bottom, though. It says, do not contact me with unsolicited services or off.
No, that's on every listing.
Oh, okay.
Or just about everyone. But this is where the tall tale seller was says... would love to find a regular workout partner. Workout, what? And then it says, pitcher needed, as in, you know, the giver. Short stick, okay. Yo!
Honestly, if they didn't have short stick in there, I would think that was like on some regular shit. But I think the short stick kind of thing is like, I don't know.
Well, I mean, this is misconnections.
This is trying to fuck, bro.
If you go on misconnections, all you see is fucking people wanting to fuck. So I was like, hey, man. But it was a creative way. To get your fucking funk on. But I feel like this is meant for like older 50-year-old fucking... Creative. Yeah, no, yeah, yeah.
It sounds like a game of catch to me.
Yeah, I can't catch what he's saying.
Felt that low-key, like, yeah.
Have you ever been on this, Antonio?
Fuck no.
Remember, we've told this on the... Yeah, I hope not.
You said fuck no.
No. We've one time... we said this on another pod with callers. Or with not callers here, but let me run it down because he is here. We found a listing for him.
Oh, okay. I think I remember.
Remember that? Yes. Did I read it out to you?
Yeah, dude. But not on the pod.
Okay. I remember my brother telling me this, and he's like, it's you. And I'm like, you're full of shit. And then halfway through, I'm like, oh, no, this is actually me.
It was
like,
coming from the source, you, it is you, right? Because I could say shit.
It's definitely, it's me for sure.
Yeah, so basically, roughly what it said, I'm not going to get too deep, but it's a place that callers is at all the fucking time. And then they described him to a T, fucking, you know, red hair, fucking, like, there was just like so much shit. And I was like, bro, this is fucking you, dude.
Yeah, I was like, damn, that's actually kind of low key crazy.
Did you reply?
Yeah, I mean, Feel me? If that's you, that's you. But that ain't my cup of tea. Respectfully, yeah, no, that just ain't
my cup of tea. For real, nah, for real. Hey, man, I kind of admire it, man. If you're on a misconnection fucking, you know, article, you might be fucking.
But like, what are the odds of someone like reaching out to you like, oh, that, I was that person. Like, the odds are super fucking slim.
Yeah. I don't that's even what think I'm saying, bro. But like, chance. Me knowing my life and my odds, like, that doesn't, it's surprising, but it doesn't surprise me.
That is true. He has some crazy luck, but what was crazy is like, bro, for whatever reason, I was just talking to him about it, yes, and then we bro. Had went on and the listings, right, and we had seen one for him, and I'm like, okay, man, that's like a one in a million. I think that is like one in a million, no, right?
No, it is, bro.
That's kind of like one
we
in a million.
We were talking about it, we went straight to it, and then there was one describing me, and we're like, what the fuck?
No, that's scary, dog.
That's crazy, huh?
That shit scares me.
All right, Antonio, I know you're into music.
Of course.
Specifically, what type of music are you into?
Hip hop, R&B, fucking soul.
Okay, this is a little left field. Reggae. Out of your range. Reggae?
Reggae, Spanish music.
Have you ever listened to like electronic, gothic, fucking, you know, synth punk, any of those fucking craziness?
No, I have not, my boy, I have not.
All right, let me fucking pop your cherry here, because we have, this. You know, this girl, I don't know where she's from. I came across from her because of, she did a collab with some other artist. But I want to get your take on this female.
That's that devil shit right there already, bro.
No.
That's that devil shit.
Hey, man, don't judge a book by its cover.
That's that devil shit, my boy. Play that shit. I want to hear it.
All right. It's good, man. All right. Let me fucking bump it up real quick.
There you go. Let's get it.
All right. Ready?
Yes, sir. Did I say sucio?
Oh, this is college, this girl right here. God damn it. She's on MySpace and shit.
She got some steez. She got a little grip, a little I swag. So
hear it out, hear it out.
Lucky fuck with the cut.
It looks like mine. First thoughts, impressions. I want to get Antonio's first.
Low key,
with no bias from us.
Low key, it's like I can see this being played like at a rave for sure, or like at a car, some kind of like fucking Japanese car event, yeah, or some yeah, shit yeah, like yeah. Like a fucking a JDM some, type of thing.
It has some inspo of that, like almost like super color, like Tokyo, Japan, like almost like, and then her style too is kind of crazy.
I feel like if you play this in the right room with the right people. They'll go crazy over it.
Do you like it? Nah. What? Come on, bro.
Nah.
I'm gonna tell you. I think it's cool. I definitely think it's different. Does it like really speak to me? Me personally, no. But like, it's cool and it's different.
She has the girl has a
I
look.
It kind of gives me like a dance.
One. I striked out. I thought somebody.
It
kind of
gives
like
me
it.
Like a dance revolution yeah, type vibe. Yeah. At least from the music video. Oh, like I said, it's cool. I like that different shit. I like people doing their own type of shit. Does it speak to me like crazy? No, but I definitely think it's cool. Like, it's different.
I will say, though, I mean, this is one of her songs, but you guys should go in, and I'll give you guys the artist name and everything. My fucking visual, I cannot see her name for the life of me, but, bro, this girl is definitely, like, she does some crazy shit.
I mean,
the music
like,
video's different.
Yeah, no, it's cool.
Like I said, yeah, like, even if it's not like my, you know, my thing, like I can still appreciate it. And yeah, like, it's cool.
I just applaud it because, I mean, obviously, like you said, it looks different. You know, girl, she's doing her like, and if you guys listen to her music, like outside of this shit, you know, she goes into like these sounds.
Is this
and, like,
Napalm? Is it the same?
Yeah,
name?
It's the same chick from Napalm.
Okay, well, I mean,
you like Napalm, right?
I like, yeah, like I like that other song. Is that what it's called, Napalm?
Yeah,
or is that her name?
No, no, that was the song name.
Okay,
what's this girl's name?
The song in Napalm goes hard.
Like, it's something with a Z. It's like Z H something. I don't know. I can't see right now. But
honestly, I like her look though, fool. Like she has drip, like, and she has hella outfits.
That's what I'm saying.
She got like she's going for it. I fuck with that. Like she's going for it.
No, yeah, it's like she don't give a fuck. You could tell, you know.
Oh, fuck no.
Yeah, yeah. And you could, yeah, like, to me, that's, like, badass, because, like, I give a fuck.
I mean, this song, like, is, like, cool, whatever, but that other song, Napalm song, like, that shit goes hard. So, like, I mean, I'm fucking with her.
No, yeah, that's cool. I love it. I mean, you guys know, like, these older fucking music videos and shit, like, to now, like, you see all these, like, fucking, I mean, this was crazy, right? It's, like, fucking, they're using, like fucking.
Say, it's, like, Dance Dance Revolution type. Yeah. Which, like, you don't really see. That's why I like it. It's different.
It reminds me of Tokyo Drift, though. Like, Tokyo Drift, that. Fast and the Furious, like. Mm-hmm.
My life be like, ooh.
That was like, that was like early, that was like early rave shit though. Like that was like 2000s raves. Like they were dressed pretty much like that. Oh,
yeah. With the high fucking boots, everything.
And I'm now it's,
that. I think that's
the tribal. I mean, those are like fake tattoos, but the tribal tattoos and shit like that, that too.
That's just making a comeback.
Yeah.
Dude, for sure it's making a comeback.
Oh, I've already seen it on people, yeah. For sure.
I forget what it's called. I think it's called like Fine Mag or some shit like, or Fine Boys or something. But it's basically like a Tokyo or like fucking Japanese magazine of like the fucking like, I think it was like 70s, 80s, and the 90s.
Rave culture?
Just like culture. Oh, okay. And like, and I got to pass you the magazines because you really like it, bro. Like
I would.
The majority of this new age shit all stems from like this shit that I'll show you guys in the magazines. It's all like Y2K, like, you know, all that shit. Mm-hmm. Like the fucking, like people like wearing the fucking, you know, it's like basically what we wear now. Like fucking, you know, it's like same shit, but it's cool. They're like pulling inspiration, but it's still unique, you know?
Yeah, no, she's fresh.
Yeah.
She got her shit going on. Like I said, this song isn't like crazy to me, but I like that Napalm song. I think that shit goes hard. And if it's the same artist.
I mean, the music is, you know, a little bit different. It's not something you could like actually like what genre is this? It's kind of like, you know, it's kind of hard to tie in. But like, how do you feel about just like music in general? You know, people are like experimenting, doing all these crazy shits with like mixing genres, sounds and everything. And that's in every field.
Yeah.
Is it like, how do you guys feel about it?
I mean, me, I feel like that's... Well, I mean, like, I feel like music reflects humans, and I feel like humans right now, we're everywhere. We do everything. We look like anything. I feel like the music is pretty much a reflection of humans. So, like, you have music that is, like, everything and anything pretty much right now. Like, you have, really you like have that. Like, sub-genres and side-genres right now, like, a motherfucker. So.
Oh, yeah. I really like how you said it. It's like a reflection of the humans, our time, who we are. And like you said, we're in a generation right now where it's like everything could be anything.
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like people are just kind of like, you know, picking shit that they like and bringing it together. And I think that's why it's like the shit that I make, like, I don't even know what to call it, bro. Like, I really don't because it's just like the shit that I like. And it's
lifestyle.
Yeah. Like, I feel like we're past like genres. Hey,
spit it, Antonio. Give him a little something.
Fuck it if I die.
Yeah, don't try.
Bitch, I'm going crazy.
Punk star.
I feel like we're like past genres and shit like that, dude. I feel like we're just.
I think that's beautiful, dude.
Like, nah, the homie calls, he do what he wants. He could give a fuck. Yeah, y'all could hate me.
Amen to that.
Nah, bro, your music, low key, when I listen to like some punk star, like Playboy shit, like just getting bitches, getting
bread, little Tracy fucking.
Nah, better than that. Like just
better than
just
that.
Some like Playboy shit. I don't know if when I listen to your sounds, I'm like, man, low key, like I'm about to act up. Like, what the fuck? Like this shit's like Playboy shit.
Let them know, callers. What's like coming
it.
Out soon?
I like it.
Oh, shit, I got some shit dropping in 2 months.
Right?
You know, it's February, it's spider season, so that's all I'm going to say.
I like that. Hey, tell them what you have dropped, spider. Though, so they can go and listen to it.
We got Punkstar Lifestyle, and then we got Gives You Hell. It's on all platforms, Spotify, Apple Music, SoundCloud. Check that shit out. I'm coming. I'm for real about that shit. Like, I'm working on that shit.
And the YouTube, where's the video at? You can drop a music video? Because I would love to see that.
And the people that are tuned into this, that shit's on the way, too. The first one.
I was really excited about him getting into music, not because I know like the type of people he's into. It's very different, and it's very like
it is.
But like you could see the reflection through his music. It's like just him, and the style is like so like different fields, but it's all tied into one, which is like interesting take on just like, you know, your music and everything.
Yeah.
No, I agree because it's like exciting. One thing like I always kind of tripped out with you too is that you you were doing it with the homie, but like you record alone, and I'm used to like. Cause I, you know, like when I would make music with the homies, it was like a group effort type of thing. Like you had to have the homies with you to make the songs.
No, I get that.
But like seeing this fool do it alone, low key like fucked me up a little bit. Cause I was like, damn, people really make music alone. Like, cause for
honestly,
a while,
I kind of prefer crazy. Like Rolly's part of the team. But to be honest, like if there was a group of people around me, I don't think I'd be able to record the same way. Like I really do like recording like alone or with Rolly. Like that's about it because I'm able to like lock in and focus on the song or whatever I'm working on, you know?
No, I get that. Yeah, I get that. Some people do
a full studio or like homies around. Like
I was used to that for a while, like just having all the homies and like sometimes you're not even contributing. You're just there kicking it, but you're making music. So I remember like seeing this fool record a few times. I was like, "Damn, this fool really,
doing nah, he's grinding, bro. He's like, this every day.
This was fighting demons. Like, what
the fuck? He's in the studio every day. Yeah. You know, getting down his shit.
Because
like,
to me, like,
no grind.
To me, when you're doing something alone, it's like you're fighting demons. Like when you're working out alone, you feel me? This fool fighting demons.
Well, that's
when
all we do, man. Amen. Fight demons.
You feel me? I'm like, damn, the homie's fighting demons.
I feel like I'm just used to doing shit like by myself or I don't know. I don't mind it. Like, I honestly prefer it, like, either myself or with Rolly. But, like, if there was a group of people here while I was trying to work on something, it wouldn't work. Like,
I'm the same way. I kind of love the privacy and almost, like just isolation. All you have is, like, you and your own thoughts. I mean, it's always good, too, to have other people, you know, their takes and everything, obviously. But it is, like, it's a different type of, like, grind, if you will, to just, like, do stuff by your own. You know? You know the same, like... I don't know. It just feels good, you know? Yeah.
No, I do. I feel like I'm an introvert naturally, but there are definitely times where I feel like being an introvert can fuck you over.
Oh, yeah. I mean, whoa. Yeah. Where you're just going too deep.
Yeah.
And you're just getting fucking nothing. You're just like, you know, you're all picky and shit.
Like I'm saying, you're just fighting demons. Like you're just like, they're all like,
I totally get it.
Fuck.
Yeah. Fuck but that. That's fucking the human. Dude, that's like me recently, bro. I've just been on this fucking shit where I'm just like... locked and loaded, but also just like because you're so isolated and loaded and fucking straight fucking going, you're just like demons.
You're like, fuck everybody, fuck anyone. I don't give a fuck.
Y'all can hate me.
That too.
That's one thing too is like I'm so like locked in, and that's why I like really being a part of it too is because I feel like I sometimes I'll be working on some shit and I'll overthink. I feel like I overthink it, bro. Like I'll be like, damn, this shit don't sound off. And it's cool because like Rolly, I know he knows his shit. So like that was the dude.
He's like a voice of reason.
Yeah, I would ask him, be like, yo, is this off? And he's like, bro, it literally sounds fine. Like,
shout out to Rolly.
So when you don't have that, I feel like you overthink it. Sometimes I'd be overthinking a little shit, you know, but.
I totally get it. Yeah.
Shout out to the roaster and the golden boy.
Yeah. Let's talk about it briefly. You know, Vroly's out in the fucking trenches right now, dude. He's fucking getting it off the boat. Lil Yachty.
I know he's staying solid though. Bro's a solid dude.
Of course.
I respect that so much. You got to go through tough shit in life. You got to do tough shit to kind of build your character. Am I right?
It's a choice.
And it's a choice.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, like,
he chose to.
Yeah.
And I kind of, it's like going to the army and shit, bro. I kind of respect it. You got to get in your bones, like you said in another pod. You know, like, let's go off for a minute.
I definitely feel that, like I said, like I was telling, I asked bro and he was like, I was like, how's it been out there? And he's like, it's been rough, bro. Like, gave me. And when I take that one, he's telling me like, "Oh, it's been rough." I'm like, "Damn, it probably is."
Nah, Rolly's a solid dude.
I
told him,
I was like, "Bro, just stay solid."
When he says it's
like,
rough, it's rough.
That's what I'm saying. I was like, "Bro, just stay solid and like,
yeah, if we know
you're straight, I know you'll be straight." But we knew it wasn't easy.
Rolly right now is on a boat in the fucking Arctic or some crazy ass fucking place,
freezing his ass off.
Freezing his ass off. I mean, I could literally
busting his ass off.
Sit here and say that I wouldn't do that shit. That's
oh
not
fuck
me.
No.
Oh no, I
fuck
do that.
What
shit.
The fuck?
That's what I'm saying. It
that's
ain't
why,
me, but
bro. I be talking that way, but like, bro, don't even do that shit, bro. Like, get the fuck out of there, bro. Like, come the fuck back over here, fool. But you're like, nah, fool. I'm going. I'd be like, God damn, the homie letting his nuts hang. I respect it. Like, go do your thing.
Sometimes you got to do that. You know what I'm saying? You got to let the nuts hang. Honestly, I feel like people don't let the nuts hang enough, you know, if anything.
I feel that. Thing,
you know?
I feel that.
Amen to that, brother. You know?
I feel like people don't, like, get out of their comfort zone enough.
Yeah.
You know? It's cool to feel comfortable, bro, but, like, I feel like to proceed and get, you know, go higher is like you got to get out of your comfort zone. You got to do shit that like you can be like
100%, dude.
You just it's part of the. I feel like it's part of the thing, bro.
I feel like that low key kind of impresses you too. Like when you do something that's out of your ordinary, and like you succeed at it, it low key kind of like gives you that confidence boost. You're like, oh fuck, exactly. Like I did that. That's exactly. What's up. Like I'm gonna keep that shit up.
That's exactly what I'd be saying. Like you got to get out of your comfort zone because then you'll see that you could do some shit out of your comfort zone and it's gonna. You know,
what was like one moment for both of you guys that you thought like you did something that was definitely out of your character, but like it succeeded and it was like, yes,
you're fucking looking at it, bro. Yes. You know what I'm saying? Like, I never thought I would be on a podcast nor like even want to present myself to the people like that, you know? And
that was my big thing at first too, is like, I was like, damn, bro, like I'm really about to be because we put ourselves in the public, like people.
Yeah, we're putting yourself out there.
Hear us. Yeah, you put
when
yourself
we could sit behind
there.
Screens, you know, and be exactly. like, nah, like, you know, I'm gonna be that mysterious motherfucker, you know.
Yeah, and I'm the type of dude where it's like I'll post or do whatever I want to do, but at the same time, it's like I don't like to really put myself out too much. So the podcasting, I was kind of weary about. I was like, I don't know if I want to like. You know, I don't know if I want people to like hear everything I'm thinking. Or,
yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
You know, just blah blah blah.
I got that too. I do that too.
Yeah, mm-hmm. But after a while, I was kind of just like, man, fuck it. Like, it is what it is, bro. Just let them. They're gonna make whatever you know out of
honestly,
it.
Honestly, I think it's added to my character, if anything, because I know you guys can feel this, but it's like it's almost like a confidence of even just like being like you don't give a fuck. You know, exactly. Like you're going to do your podcast. You're going to fucking, you know, speak your mind. You're going to do your shit. Who gives a fuck how people perceive you? Who gives a fuck about like, you know, who's judging you and all these shits? You know, at the end of the day, it's like we're fucking grinding and we're going to get the shit in the bag, you know? So it's like,
who that's pretty much, that's pretty much how it hit me too. I was just like, I already don't give a fuck about a lot of shit. So I was just like, eh, I don't give a fuck about this shit either. Like,
you know, did you have that, Antonio? Like, you did you ever feel like almost like that, like not doubt, but like that, like, oh, like maybe I shouldn't be doing this. Did you ever feel like that?
Yeah, I feel like that's where I was like saying the isolation, the introvert in me, because like I do that. I isolate a lot. I'm an introvert like naturally. Mm-hmm. And then when you get like isolate yourself, you just put shit into your head.
Yeah.
A lot. So I've had moments like that too, where I'm like, fuck, like, I don't know if I could do this shit. But like, I'm not gonna lie though. Like one person that's always like, has always pushed that was my mom. High key, like my mom was always like I could tell my mom like, hey, my mom finna go to the moon, and she'll be like, hey, Fubo, bring me a rock when you come back.
So I love that. God. I like that.
So my mom was kind of like, she's always like, that's like probably one of the main people that's like, hey, Fubo, go for it, like whatever
shit,
it is.
That shit goes a long ways too, because your mom could really be the opposite. She could be like, bro, don't do that shit. Like,
yeah, yeah.
I feel like same thing with our parents is like they always encourage us, and I feel like you know that.
There's a lot of doubt in the world, bro. You know how many people are around us that probably just like, eh, whatever, you know, like look another way. But at the end of the day, it's just like, you're going to do you, you know, you guys are going to like do what you guys want. And it's like, dude, that's it. You know, it's like, fuck what the people have to say. Fuck all that shit. You know, let's get it in the bag.
Yeah, bro. Cause he, fuck yeah. If we got life and shit, this, the homies.
Just do a bottle update.
Hey, yo, bottle update.
You know, I don't drink, but I'm about to finish.
Antonio's coming in last. You better,
I'm about to demolish this shit.
All right. What if we just kill it right here? Are we going to cheers and kill it?
I don't got that in me.
Oh, okay. What about you, callers?
I mean, I got this in me.
You fools are alcoholics.
He knows me. I don't even drink like that. You don't even drink.
Honestly, getting in the 40s to college right now, this is kind of a step
up.
It's kind of
crazy, right? Because I, dude, like.
But he's killing, and he's killing all of us, guys.
I love it.
I don't really drink, but my brother's like, this is what we're doing. I'm just like, well, let's do it then.
Beards.
And respect, homie. You know what I'm saying? Homie's just like, we're fucking doing it, bro.
Homie's being a man. Like, what, you feel me? Like, the homie's drinking a beer and shit like that. He has his shades on. You feel me? Like, this won't give a fuck right now.
You Y'all can me? Hate me. No kids.
I don't lie in the music, bro. That shit is real as fuck.
I don't lie in the music.
That shit's real.
What about that one line?
What about that one line? Yeah, for real.
You said this, this, and this.
Yeah, I think my hands are going blue, dude. Hey, man, I don't think I can feel my hand,
No,
dude.
My hand is cold, though, but, like...
Nah, I'm just playing. Dude, nah, it's totally fine.
Nah, we need this.
That was one thing I was concerned about. Antonio, you told me, he's like, dude, our hands are going to be freezing. I didn't even think about it for some reason. I was like,
dude,
oh,
somebody
shit,
said that on
will.
The live. They were like, you guys forgot the gloves. And I was like, oh, you're supposed to put gloves like when you do this?
Nah, they're fucking pussies.
Yeah,
they're
pussies,
fucking
bro.
Pussies, bro. We don't need no gloves, bro. I know I put tape in my hand. I'm like, oh, gloves are pussy. That's that pussy shit.
Amen to that, dude. Fuck that pussy shit.
I'm dead.
All right. This is take two, Antonio. Let me see if you fuck with this. It's a little bit more down your lane.
I think
you Chirac inspo. You know, these people are called Cemetery. They're from the fucking Great Alps of fucking where?
Haunted Mound.
What the fuck?
Oh, they're called Haunted Mound from where?
Cemetery is the artist. I think they're from Northern California. I think
they're from
NorCal? Bro.
They're from Sac?
Like Sacramento.
From Big Sac Town, you know?
Sheesh, play it, my boy. I need this. And wait up. This looks demonic too. You feel me? So like, let's get it out the way.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Demonic number two. Let's go in.
I'm in my bitch mouth when I blame my chains on hell. Sound like the screams of hell. One day so hard, watch your skin turn out. Grab a tag, pull up with some knives. Do your funky lucky town. I was making job up. You can't tell me shit now. Stay in my haunted house. I call it the butcher house. Murder house, the house. Haunted house, my butcher house. Look at my belt and my chain and my watch partner. Look at my knives and my guns and my soul partner. I flex so damn hard you think it was a funeral. Lord forgive me, I'd highway to hell forever. Haunted mound, reapers put you down.
All right, a couple seconds.
All right, so
I can't even wait, show it real quick. He's got the merch. He's a big rapper of Haunted Mound.
For sure.
I fuck with him, bro. You fuck with him. I fuck with artists. Like, all right. I love artists.
What do you think, Antonio?
So are they ever going to blow up? I don't think so.
They're already blown up.
I don't see. I mean, I feel like they might have their group like everyone else has, but I don't see it getting big. But one thing though, like aesthetically, like the shit they're rocking, the shit mm-hmm. they're like the stees and shit like that, the stilo, that shit's trendy as fuck. Like they're low key on some like they got some swag. Like
their tour right now, like they're selling the fuck out of it, bro. Like they're adding dates and selling those.
Yeah, like, I think they have like 20 different locations and they sold out. But let me just say,
so let's say, well, let me hear the states. I'm trying to hear this. Like, do you know the states or like?
Is yeah, it, bro. No, like, dude, they're going
top of the line, yes, bro. Like, San Antonio, Texas, LA, like deep LA,
everywhere.
Like they're but let me just say, I totally get where you're coming from, Antonio. Because when I initially heard this, Collis was the one to put me on it. He's the originator, the founder. I was like, okay, these guys are cool. They got their own thing going, but they're not going to reach a lot of people.
But and I totally told get you that. I told you these guys are going to blow up, bro.
Exactly, and he did.
Because there's an audience.
Yeah, everybody. I just don't think it's my lane.
Which I totally get. But I was like, okay, this is a little too deep in the niches for. Damn, Collars.
That's just dumb.
God damn, Collars.
The homie's faded. This was faded as well.
Let's keep the pod going. He's gonna say some shit.
Faded as where's the knife? That shit's done, my boy.
Nah, leave that shit.
Leave it on.
Nah, you could cut it. Fuck it.
Yeah, I already finished the bitch.
Well, what I was basically saying was, like, I get it, dude. They're, like, a little too demonic, a little too much, you know? And their sound's a little too much. So it's very, like, niche-oriented.
Yeah,
like,
it is.
For, like, a specific person. But they do have potential because they're different a little bit. And to me, I just find it kind of interesting.
It is. But I think the aesthetic, it's like with the girl.
Yeah.
To me, it was more like the aesthetic, like, the way she dressed. Same thing with these fools, like, the True Religion jeans, like, True Religion head to toe. Like, that was, like, Chief Keef era, like...
You can see the ties, bro. That's some of the people they really fuck with is like the Chief Keef shit.
And that's what I'm telling you. Like now there's like subgenres and genres right now. Like that would be considered drill.
Yeah.
Basically, that's like drill.
Like a goth drill. Punk. Drill.
Yeah, goth drill. So like
that. Damn.
You feel me? So that shit, I could see it bumping, but like I said, like, but if they're doing good, hey, you feel me? Like,
yeah,
shit,
bless
you
up.
Feel me? I'm finna shut the fuck up. Like, keep it up.
No, that's what I'm saying. I definitely hear what you're saying. Like I said, it's you get me? Like, you know what's for you and what's not for you. Like, if it's not for you, that's totally fine. But they're doing some cool shit. I fuck with them.
What I like to do is kind of show Antonio the fucking far left, you know, like music and like the shit going on.
I do stick to like my shit. Like I just stick to what I know.
Yeah, and I know you're like not coming across this type of shit, you know, like this dude fucking in the depths of fucking the internet. But I was just like, let me just get Antonio's look. How do you feel about all this demonic shit? The witchcraft, the butcher house, autoholics.
Nah, dude. My boy, that should be. Hey, you feel me? You get what you give.
What do you mean by that?
You feel me?
Drewski.
I got the wiggers on me.
You get what you give,
you
my boy.
You mean by that?
You get what you give, fool. Like you, if that's what you're putting out there, my boy, that's what you're finna get. You feel me? You're acting. That's if you're fucking around with that type of shit, that's what you're finna get.
Whole bunch of goth bitch pussy. God damn it. That's what you get back when you look like this.
Nah, I mean, like, I'm not really like the. It's not my steez, like I said. Like, it's not my thing, but. If that's what they're into, like, hey, you feel me? Like, I'll power do them. Like, if that's their aesthetic, like, demonic shit.
Yeah.
Hey, fool, like, keep it up. If it sells, I mean, I got my shit, too. You feel me? I like you feel me? I like duality. I like certain things like that. You feel me? I like guns and shit like that. So, hey, you feel me? Like
duality.
Dude.
Colors.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
What is your take on The Butcher House?
I fuck with them, bro. I think they got some cool shit going on. I think they're doing their own thing. I love any artist. Like, any artist that's doing their own thing, bro, even if I'm, like, not into it, I definitely appreciate that shit. You know, it's the same shit. Totally. Like, I'm sure you can sell me some shit. That I'm like, bro, that shit's fire. Like, that shit's cool. But maybe it's not some shit I listen to all the time, you know? But I still always appreciate, like, people that are just doing their own shit. And honestly, I mean, I like the shit that they do. I feel like it's some spooky shit. It's always been, like, some shit that I'm into. So that's why I like it. And that's
why I support it. Can I ask, how the fuck did you find these guys? Because you're the originator. You're the founder.
For real, bro. You're the one that tied us in.
Dude, I seen them, like, I seen their name coming up, like, on Instagram, like, people playing their music. As a haunted mount. I'm into spooky shit, so once I hear haunted, I'm like, let me look in. So I started looking into them. I was like, damn, I kind of... At first, it did kind of catch me off guard. I wasn't sure if I really fucked with it that crazy, the music-wise.
Yeah, because it's a little
aesthetic-wise,
much.
Like, I did. I was like, oh, this is cool. This is some shit that I kind of do, like, on, you know, like, on the same lane. But music-wise, I wasn't sure. At first, I was kind of like... I would listen to your music, and I was like, I don't know. But the big thing is, like...
I'm looking at the levels. I'm looking at his. I'm like, who's going to finish it first?
Fuck you, Elijah. I'm going to finish
it. Nah, let's finish it together. You know what I'm saying? God damn it. You know what I'm saying?
But a big thing is, like, that shit, I feel like a lot of shit grows on me. And it was just cool after a while. I was just like, yeah, I'm fucking with it.
High life. No high. If you want, you can cut it off first. I'll keep the combo going.
Go ahead.
They just, or Cemetery dropped it. He's like the, I would say, like, the leader of the Haunted Mound. Mm-hmm. He just dropped the mixtape, and I think that shit's fire. Like, there's some bangers on there that I could show you. Like,
but they, I'm interested to see it.
I'm fucking with what they're doing. I think, like, other people have done that shit in the past, and I think it was just too early for people to appreciate it like that. And I think, like, now they're just doing it at a good time where people can appreciate it.
I mean, they're in the stew with FTP, Zach from FTP.
That's what I'm saying. So it's like, it's, you get me? Exactly. That shows you that, like, other people are fucking with it too, you know?
It's amazing.
I like
it. Man.
That's why I bought the shirt too. I was like, I fuck with them. For real.
I seen this hat by Bones. You know,
is it the teen witch one?
Dude,
I want to buy it, dude. Because, like,
did you,
bro,
it's that, sold out, you fuckers. Dude, you got it before us,
dude. Because the, like, teen witch, like, bro, that's a big,
that's the originator,
bro. When I got onto Bones, bro, I want to say I got onto Bones in like 2013. Like, that's when I hopped onto the Bones,
yeah.
And teen witch was like, bro, I think that
the founders,
that
the godfathers.
Whole album. Is so good because he
that's
did
the
something
name of the
different.
Album?
Like, nobody's doing that back then. Like, yeah, it was a whole album, right?
Called Teen Witch?
It's called Teen Witch. Okay. But he basically, like, the whole album story or, like, plot is basically based around the Columbine shooters. So he's basically making songs, like, in their, like, POV.
Mindset.
In their mindset. It's something different. It's kind of crazy, you know? But, like, who's doing that? And I feel like when you're doing different crazy shit, it's like, it's cool, bro.
The only song I've heard by Bones was the Canal Street way ASAP Rocky.
Did you like
that's
it?
That's a good
though?
One, too, because
hey
that originates, that originates from one of his...
it is.
Yeah. That originates
did you like
from
it?
One of
yeah.
his other songs.
That was probably my favorite. That was probably one of my favorite ASAP songs. Like, every time me and the homies would kick it, hey, play Canal Street.
Exactly.
But Bones is... I had like, my little moment where I was into, like, that, like, Bones, like, Schema Posse or, like, GBC.
Mm-hmm.
But it was, like, short-lived.
I thought it was GBC.
Hey, man, who's, you know, we talked about the forefathers, Team Sesh, Sesh, all the water boys. Who's the fucking forefathers of fucking Baby Boy?
Sheesh, my boy.
Like, who are the people that you just set the lane for just, like, you? Who you are as a person? It's, like, music interest in general.
I felt like Glory Boys, for sure.
Oh, shit.
Dude, yeah. I was a big, like, so I was super into Chief Keef, fucking Boss Top, like,
yeah,
all those fools,
yeah.
Bro, like, I was really into that shit.
Yeah,
especially
it was like Chief Keef, Lil Reese, Fredo,
yes,
Boss
bro.
Top, 2014, Big Low.
2013, like, I was crazy yeah. into that, dude.
My guy was Fredo Santana, dude.
Fredo
was fucking...
You're talking about groups or individuals?
I mean, whichever, dude.
We'll go groups.
You said Glory Boys, that's
yeah, so
one.
That I would go GBE for sure, like, that was... GBE was tough. OTF.
OTF,
Lil Durk. That was, damn. That was like my era.
I'm newer onto that shit, but I fuck
yeah.
with it.
Yeah,
like, I fuck with Lil Durk. Like,
yeah. I think the Chirac, like the Glory Boys was heard round world, and like, bro, all those people like you just said, bro, were just like fucking for culture in general. Is
yeah.
just kind of the fucking
dude,
role.
The swag.
Chief Keef, like, yeah, that food did his shit, bro. Like, he really
and he's still doing his shit. He just did a. Have you seen Trippie Redd's new album?
No, I have not.
Okay. Yeah, it's whatever, but
I haven't listened to it. I know it's whatever, music, bro. But
he did this collab with Chief Keef, and it's called, I think I want to call it like, I forget what it's called, but it's honestly like one of the hardest Chief Keef songs that I've heard in a minute. Really good. I'll play for you guys after this, but wow, dude, it's a fucking great song.
Yeah, like I would say like the whole like drill scene, even like their ops, like FBG Doug and shit like that, Lil JoJo. Like I'm a fan of like hip hop point blank period. So it don't matter what side, but that too. And then like I feel like YG.
Dude, I was big into YG.
Yeah. YG was
big into YG. What's the white album cover that he did?
Oh, I know what you're talking about, but yeah.
When that shit came out, bro, that's when I was like fully fledged into YG.
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, that shit was fucking awesome.
Wasn't it called Bompton?
Oh yeah, it was Bompton. Bompton.
I don't know, but there's a song like on that album.
It had the one with Drake, the feature. Like,
yeah, that whole album. Yeah. Like my homie put me onto that shit, and I was just like, yeah, I'm fucking with YG, like crazy. Bro. Before that, I think the only single he had that was hot was like Tootin' and Boot It.
Yeah,
everyone knows that song back then.
I say what's up.
Now YG, I mean,
that was a big YG fan.
That was like fuckboy music. YG
fan too, bro.
YG had that fuckboy music. You just want to fuck a bitch when you play that shit.
You just want to hit licks, bro.
Dude, yeah, the one song where he's talking about like hitting the fucking lick in the house.
Flocking.
You know? Flocking. There you go.
That's what it's called. Meet the Flockers. That's what it's called.
Meet the Flockers. There you go.
He's literally giving you a step by step on how to hit a lick inside a crib.
Yeah.
And then you know what's crazy?
That one that he told, or where him and his homie went to go rob the liquor store, and then like
the cops came,
and then like him and his homie started shooting at each other and shit. Bro, I love that album. Like I used to listen to that shit religiously.
Hey, why'd you do it a lot, bro? I feel like people don't give him his fucking flowers.
He did.
He did a fucking lot, dude. Like,
bro, he came out with that little mini documentary series that was about like his it was about that album, the Bompton album, like right around the Bompton album when it dropped. He dropped like a little like mini movie.
I love it, bro. It's like 30 minutes long.
Yeah, I think it's called like My Crazy Life or something like that.
Yeah, I love that shit.
But
bro,
he did like one like a day in a life, like, and bro, like low key, like
my that shit
was
life.
Oh yeah, something like that. Like it was
with
tough.
A B.
It was tough, bro. Shit, bro. I was like low key, like damn, like he's at the gas station, like that's some shit, low key.
They also have the Meet the Flockers where they like actually go hit, you know, the
I'm not even
going to
cap. Like when I do my own thing like that, low key, like that fool was an influence. Like I'd be looking at his shit like, damn, bro. Like, and he will upload it on YouTube like off the strength. That's fucking tough. But
yeah, he was like one of the first people to like really go pro YouTube with music videos and like
he was doing some cool shit.
It was like a mini movie.
That 30 minute mini movie is like that. If you haven't seen that shit by YG, like that shit's fire, bro. The production,
bro, it's deep too. Like they shoot
it.
Yeah,
it correlates
with
the album. Like it was phenomenal, and that's why I was so tapped into that shit. And my homie put me onto that shit. You know, that's kind of out of my lane because like, around that time, bro, like, I'm a skater, bro. Like, that's not really my lane. But, like, when he put me onto that shit, I was like, no, I could definitely fuck with this. Like, I appreciate it.
No, it was gas. I remember listening to those old albums, like, just on some, like, young demonist shit, you know, just, like, ready to fucking rob liquor stores. No, I'm just kidding. But, like, you know, I was just, like, listening to fucking My Breezy Life and shit, or just, like, his albums. And I was like, God damn it, dude, this guy's fucking ass nuts crazy.
That shit was fire. I seen him perform.
Pajorn?
I seen him perform some fucking songs at Coachella like 2018, 2019.
Hey, this Miller High Life getting to you, ain't
it? Sheesh.
We're not gonna lie.
But the next one for sure would be the old ASAP Mob.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
so that's baby
ASAP was
boy.
A big
Goldie,
one too.
Peso. Like
I'll give really you one
back
more.
Back in the day.
Give you
one more just to make it five.
Yeah,
but,
let me see.
For sure, like off the top of my head, the whole Florida thing, like with Smoke Perp, Lil Pump,
all those fools,
Puya X, Ski Mask.
Where
for
is
sure,
Suicide
Boys
all
from,
coming
for
up
sure.
from the same? Suicide Boys are from New Orleans. They were all coming up from like the same shit, bro. Like Florida was popping at the same time. These fools were all going up together.
No, that was definitely its own age too. I mean, you see fucking Lil Pump trying to make a comeback. I just feel like he had his time, you know, and it really hit and it resonated. Now it's kind of like, it's a little different.
It's too woke now.
Yeah, it's too.
I feel like music moves fast too.
That is true.
I feel like everything.
But I feel like Lil Pump, like if I were to meet that fool, I fuck with that fool.
Oh, I definitely
fuck with that. I fuck with you, my boy.
He did a lot. I mean, I feel like he's the first Tekashi 6ix9ine in, like, the music industry. People hate him. He's polarizing, you know, right or left, you know. I think that was, like one of the first people to be like that, you know?
Yeah, right? Viral.
Yeah, viral. Like, a viral artist just off of, like, entertainment.
And he was young, too. Like, that's what people, a lot of people forget. Bro, he was 16, 17 when he blew up 18. And, like, he was just wilding, bro. Like,
fucking doing crazy shit at 16. Lil Pump, man. Jesus Christ, definitely had his time.
It's crazy.
I think the internet and music moves so fast. Like,
sadly, doesn't it feel like you said, it moves very fast?
You gotta think, bro, like, Famous Dex was crazy. Oh,
Famous Dex, dude. What's his iconic fucking verse?
Oh man, goddamn.
Yeah. I remember him doing Rolling Loud when Rolling Loud had first came out. Like, his shows were crazy, dude. Like, I remember watching video footage. They were insane,
bro.
And now he does perks and he can't fucking.
Bro, that's what I tell, bro. Like, that's what I, like, I said this in another podcast, but bro, like, that the drugs,
yeah,
leave that shit alone, fool.
Like, I totally get where you come
drop
from.
Drop that shit. Like, if you're doing it, drop it. Don't fuck with like it. Like, don't, bro, because, like, Famous Dex had, like, so much potential, and you could tell he had a good heart. Like, he was always, like, very personable.
I get the vibe that he's actually, like, a really cool, chill person.
Yeah, but I totally agree. It was, like, the drugs that, like, people start doing them, they make music, and then guess what? It becomes a crutch.
Yeah.
Fuck that shit. Like, if, honestly, like, if I were to tell anybody, if when it comes down to drugs, hate that shit.
Yeah, hate
the fuck out of it. Like, if you don't,
I don't think,
like,
anybody can say, like, drugs have always benefited me, you know. Like I said, I think they always, like, it's probably put off the problem, you know.
Honestly, I hate drugs, fool. Like, I hate them bitches, bro. Like,
at the end
of
the day, I feel like, bro, you gotta face the demons and do your shit, you know. Like,
that too, man. I mean, yeah, dude. Like you said, no drug has really ever aided somebody. If they say it aids them, it's probably because they're fucking addicted. There's no lie around it. It's either, you know, you're addicted or you're just fucking, you know. There's no in between, bro. And you see it through Famous Dex. Motherfucker was doing great, got into drugs, had to go to rehab, lost his whole momentum, fell off. Now he can barely get a fucking, you know, collab on some fucking music. Career's gone, he's not making money. It's like.
And a great person, too.
A great person. He was a cool person.
Great person.
He was a great person. And it's just like, I mean, it was all because of drugs. So it's like, you know, what are you going to do? You know?
Nah, bro. I just don't know. I go too hard on that shit, but I just don't.
No, I think you should, bro. I really hate that shit. I feel the same way.
It's like even my homies, I get why people do that shit. You get me? Like, I have the understanding of why you do that shit. Mm-hmm. But in the long run, like I said, I think it just pushes your problems to the side, you know. But eventually, it's like you got to face. You get me? You got to face that shit. So
yeah,
you keep pushing it to the side for however long you want.
Yeah,
but eventually, you got to face it. So I feel like. Me personally, it's like, bro, just face that shit and you'll grow as a person.
Well, I mean, I'm the kind of homie where, like, if any of my homies want to do, like, pills, perks, coke, or whatever, I'm the type of homie I'd be like, hey, fool, like, I'll be pulling you aside and be like, fool, cut that shit out. Like, whatever if you want to do that shit when I'm around. But when I'm around, just know I ain't finna stand for it. Because, like, I don't like that shit. That shit's is junky shit. Like, don't even touch it. Leave it alone. It is what it is. Like, move on. Like, fuck that. Like, I don't really play with that shit, honestly. Like, even if you fools were to do it, like, in front of me, I'd be like, fuck no, don't do that shit. And low key, like, if you were to even trip on me about it, like, oh, fool, like, I do what I want, then low key, I'll be like, what's up, fool? Like, then take care of your business.
Because you just feel so strongly about it.
Because, honestly, that's okay. It's because my homies are my homies. Like, I don't want to see my homies go down that path that Famous Dex went down.
Yeah,
or you have just, like, their, a million fucking
yeah,
people on
yeah, exactly,
have,
like
their best interests.
Yeah, like, low key, like,
to be like their fucking mom or something.
Yeah, like, I'm like, nah, fool, like, fly straight. Like, let's take care of business. Like, let's be cool. Let's be, like, level headed and let's keep pushing. Like, don't fucking touch that shit. You feel me? Like, straight up. That's how I am.
I think you're totally correct. I think it's maybe this whole culture around centered, you know, music, you know, perks. It's in fucking, you know, just drugs in general and music. And it's so, like, culturally accepted to do fucking drugs. Bro, I feel like 20 years ago, if you seen some motherfucker, like, doing perks and shit, you would call him a fucking weirdo. Like, you would just straight up look at him and be like, bro, you're a weirdo. Like, you do fucking pills. Like, you're a weirdo. Like, don't ever, like, you just feel some type of way. And now it's like,
drugs
now it's like,
kind of normalized now.
They are normalized, bro.
Like I said, sadly, I understand why people do it and stuff, but like I said, I don't
like the whole lean shit, bro. Like, imagine if you seen some fucking kid walking around with a bottle like that, like when you're in like fifth grade, you'd be like, that kid's a weirdo, bro. Like, get the fuck away from me, type shit. Like, now it's like, oh, food, that fool's sipping, you know? Like,
oh, yeah, who gives, cool, yeah. Yeah, he's cool, that fool's chill.
Get the fuck away from me.
It became normalized, which, like, I mean,
I got homies that do it, like, they do their thing, but like at the end of the day, it's like, damn, like when I be seeing that shit low key be breaking my heart. I'd be like, damn, fool, like you got so much potential in your life. Don't just fuck it off on no like pill or nothing like that or no drink. Like, and I get it. You feel me? Like, you be going through a hell of pain in your life. You want to numb your shit. I've been there. I've done it too. Mm. Well, not with drugs, but like, I get it. Like, and you resort to pills or lean to do that, but like, come on, fool, like man up a little bit, fool, face that shit. Man.
That's what I was saying. It's like, I understand why people do that shit, but like at the end of the day, bro, you gotta face the demons and do your shit. You know, once you do that, I feel like you really do grow as a person. Like, you know what I mean?
It takes a real man or woman to really just like deal with your shit and not have to resort to like some stuff like that. You know, and I think that's like the ultimate like, you know, you can't succumb to drugs. You can't succumb to suicide.
It ain't easy, bro. Like, nobody's saying it's easy. That shit ain't
easy. It ain't easy, bro. You know, but it takes a real person, a real motherfucker to get through some shit. And I have to resort to some stuff like that.
I'm telling you, I feel like it'll definitely benefit you in the long run. Like, you will grow as a person, bro. Mm.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Hate it.
Make yourself stronger.
Hate it first.
This Miller High Life got me high. Or some shit, because I'm motherfucking chilling over here.
Look, you gotta take a piss. Yeah.
How bad?
Not bad.
Go 1 to 10. All right, let's keep it going. Okay, on a lighter. Okay, we just went two. When Antonio's here, you know, we go deep in this bitch. You know, don't fucking play with me.
Nah,
bro.
Because that shit be hitting my heart. Because, like, I lost people to that shit. And so, like, I be going hard on it.
Totally
but,
get it. Totally
but
get
like
it.
When I fuck with people, I'll let y'all know. Hey, don't do it. Point blank.
Like
period.
I like how you stand by your beliefs.
You have a good like mindset behind it. It's not like you're just trying to be on people's ass. Oh, just
fuck
to be on
no.
Ass,
yeah.
Oh,
no. Yeah. Fuck no. I mean, that's hey, I run away from my problems too. You feel me?
Yeah. I go through some shit too.
For real. You feel me? And low key, I be doing it with this, but it ain't no biggie.
Wait, with what?
The 40, bro.
Oh, the
alcohol. You feel me? Sheesh, my boy. That
beer. Totally get that too. All right, we're going to watch, on a lighter note, you know, we're going to go through some TikToks.
Let's run it.
I'm going to show you three of them, just a couple comments, talk about it. This is my favorite TikTok on TikTok. Let's see if you guys find it funny or just ridiculous.
Ah, you wanker. Oh. Hello, you fuckers. Come off the caver here. I'm in a little bit of a sticky situation. I've gone through an opening about the size of your mum's fanny. And my cock seems to have gotten stuck on a pebble. I'm pretty fucked. My flashlight's running low. My oxygen's almost non-existent. And my balls are shredding to pieces as we speak. On the upside, I have found this bit of bat shit. So that's going to be my lunch for the next couple of days. Oh, fucking hell. Oh, fuck. Cockroach in my ass. Fucking hell. Oh, you little fucker. Look, if I don't make out alive, I want my kids to know they're a fucking disappointment. Over and out.
What the fuck?
Cockroach in my ass, you fucker.
I'm fucking dead, bro. Bro, this guy has the best impressions.
I'm fucking
dude,
dead.
This guy's obviously from the UK. I need this guy on the podcast, bro. I need this guy on the podcast. I've gone for a cave the size of your mom's fanny.
I'm not even lying. I'm well, dead,
that
food
reminds me of Gordon Ramsay.
Yeah. Well, that's where it's. Yeah. I mean, oh, he's from the UK, has a British accent, but like, bro, this guy's hilarious. His impressions are fucking crazy.
I'm not even lying, bro. I'm fucking dead, bro.
Fuck.
I'm fucking dead.
I shriveled my balls.
He said, I'm eating this bad shit.
That's going to be my lunch for this hour. He's like,
I'm not even lying, bro. That shit was funny as hell, bro.
Oh, man.
How the fuck does a cockroach come up your ass?
Did you see the header, though, right? It says, people... like
the
those,
cave guys yeah, that go, the cave that, guys. That go cave crawling.
I was like, dude, this guy's spot on with this shit, bro.
Pleasure in my stomach. Yeah.
Hey, isn't that like, dude, I think this is the funniest fucking video I've seen on the internet so far.
That shit's
funny. On TikTok, at least.
Fuck, bro, that fool was funny as fuck.
That shit's funny. I'm not
even... he's like one of my favorite... All right, callers, I need you to turn around. I need you to turn around. Hey, yo, why is this callers in 30 years, though?
Stop,
man. Stop. All right. On to the next one.
The devil's are part of the vocal work into a monster. Go. Death from the sky. Death from the sky.
I'm dead.
Callers, is this you in 20 years?
The fuck no, bro. I'm fucking dead.
What's the monster?
I'm dead as fuck.
Bro, how old is that guy, bro? What the fuck?
Dude, his mascara. I'm not gonna play, but look. Just look at this guy right here, Callers.
Oh, bro, he his does have mascara is like, on, bro.
That looks like Roderick from fucking Dinosaurs.
Bro, he does, huh?
Dude, I fuck with Roderick, though.
From American Dad?
That shit, honestly, it's just funny as fuck.
Diary of a Wimpy Kid.
Oh, yeah.
American Pie, that's a different one.
No, I said
Diary. Let's get a screenshot of this guy, though. This gives me callers energy.
Oh, that shit was... Bro, that first video had me dead, foo.
That shit...
And tonight I see...
that I will fall for you.
That I will fall for you.
Dude. I gotta take a piss.
All right. Last one.
Last one.
This is it right here. All right, this is on a lighter note. Let me just, dude, this is like amazing. Lighter note, let's go.
Odio las mentiras, pero adoro a mi familia y por ellos yo voy a luchar y la cruz del otro que buen mi pecho ranchito que no he olvidado. Vive mi infancia, pero ya tengo ganancias y gracias a dos llantas. Mos bien vestidos, zapatito fino, los que me deben por estar.
One word, it's not about what you do, it's about how you do it.
That's what I was going to say.
Am I right?
I fuck with it. I respect the hustle.
Bro, I'm trying to eat that shit. Whatever the fuck that is, I'm trying to eat that shit.
It's not about what you do, it's about how you do it. This guy's fucking selling hot dogs. But bro, he's going in, he's going crazy. Like, bro, you could see the crowd. Like, yeah. It's respectable. And I think that's what it's all about. It's finding whatever, you know, you're good at or what you like and do it to the best of your potential. And that's the greatest example right there.
I feel like that's how you do it. It's like...
That shit made my heart warm.
That's what I'm saying.
I love it, bro. You know what I'm saying? I fucking love it. Like I said, if bro's selling hot dogs, it could be as simple as that. I feel like
they look like those Mexican hot dogs too. You feel me?
Yeah, they're fucking dude. That shit's gas.
I love it. I love everything about it.
I need. Honestly, I'm gonna have to fuck with that.
I love everything about it.
I'm gonna fuck with that.
That when I saw this video, like you said, it warmed my heart. But also too, I was just like, dude, you know, he could just be some regular fucking other, you know, guy just selling hot dogs and shit. But like, no, he really fucking cares. He's going crazy. He's giving them a performance, and I feel like, bro. It doesn't matter what you do. You got to do it to your best of your potential. You have to be in it 100%, you know, whether it's hot dog flipping, fucking selling flowers in the corner, doing whatever it is you do in life, career, whatever, do it 110%. Because if you don't, you're getting replaced by these motherfuckers, you know, the people that do care.
That's what I'm saying. I fucking love it, bro. Like, honestly, like, exactly. Bro could just be making some regular hot dogs and that shit's cool, whatever. But I love how he takes it to the extra extent, puts more fucking energy, you know, heart behind it. Mm. You can feel that shit, bro. You can see it. Like, I love it. I love everything about it.
I love it.
All right. Any last comments on it, Antonio? Anything else?
That shit was beautiful. You feel me? I'm going to have to go fuck with one real quick.
Dude, honestly.
You feel me? And hey, you know what? At the end of the day, I love being Mexican.
Amen to that. Amen to that. Amen to that. All right. On another note. The Graveyard. Thank you guys for watching Edward 40 Hands. It was a great episode. I think this was a fucking amazing episode. You guys are fucking amazing. The brothers, you know, we're going to go out on this note, watching it one more time. Callers, you can go ahead and take your piss. We're closing right now. Peace, guys.
Ah, you later, wanker. Oh. Hello, you fuckers. Come on, the caver here. I'm in a little bit of a sticky situation. I've gone for an opening about the size of your mum's.
You know what's crazy is that they go into that cave knowing they're gonna do this shit.
I'm pretty fucked.
Wait, let me see.
My flashlight's running low. My oxygen's almost non-existent, and my balls are shredding to pieces as we speak. On the upside, I have found this bit of bat shit, so that's going to be my lunch.
He said, "You know, he said, grab like a raisin and just eat that shit."
Oh fuck!
That would have been
fucking just got a raisin.
Cockroach, you little fucker!
You little fucker!
Look, if I don't make out alive, bro, I want my kids to know that fucking disappointment. Over and out.
Over and out. Peace,
bro. That's like Gordon Ramsay, fool.